Kate and William issue solemn response to Prince Philip's death as they unite in grief. Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, and Prince William have issued a solemn response to the death of Prince Philip as the royal family unite in grief. The Duke of Edinburgh has died at the age of 99, Buckingham Palace has said. Kensington Palace, the household of Kate and William, retweeted the sad news shared by the official royal family account on its Twitter feed. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge are yet to issue any other response following the sad news. Prince Philip passed away peacefully on Friday morning at Windsor Castle. In a statement, Buckingham Palace said, "It is with deep sorrow that Her Majesty the Queen announces the death of her beloved husband, His Royal Highness the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. His Royal Highness passed away peacefully this morning at Windsor Castle. Further announcements will be made in due course." The royal family join with people around the world in mourning his loss. The Duke was the longest-serving consort in British history and would have celebrated his 100th birthday in June. He was married to the Queen for more than 70 years and dedicated decades of his life to royal duty, serving the nation at the monarch's side. Philip officially retired from public service in the summer of 2017 after completing more than 20,000 engagements. Prince Philip recently returned to Windsor after spending a month in hospital, his longest ever stay. He was taken to King Edward VII's hospital in central London on February 16 for treatment for an infection. The Duke was later transferred to St. Bartholomew's Hospital for heart surgery for a pre-existing condition. He was moved back to the King Edward VII's hospital and was discharged on March 16. The Duke left the hospital in a wheelchair and was then driven in a car to be reunited with the Queen, 94. Boris Johnson is leading the nation's tributes and said, "We give thanks, as a nation and a kingdom, for the extraordinary life and work of Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh." Speaking from outside number 10, the Prime Minister said the Duke earned the affection of generations here in the United Kingdom, across the Commonwealth and around the world. Mr. Johnson added, "Above all, he will be remembered for his steadfast support for Her Majesty the Queen." He said, "And it is to Her Majesty, and her family, that our nation's thoughts must turn today, because they have lost not just a much-loved and highly respected public figure, but a devoted husband and a proud and loving father, grandfather and, in recent years, great-grandfather." London Mayor Sadiq Khan tweeted, "Today, we mourn the loss of an extraordinary man, who devoted his life to public service and helping others. I extend my deepest sympathies to Her Majesty the Queen and the entire royal family at this sad time." Tributes have also poured in from leading political and royal figures from around the world. European Commission President Ursula von der Leyen tweeted, "I am saddened to hear of the passing of His Royal Highness Prince Philip. I would like to extend my sincere sympathy to Her Majesty the Queen, the royal family and the people of the United Kingdom on this very sad day." King Carl XVI Gustaf of Sweden said, "The Queen and I were deeply saddened to learn of the death of His Royal Highness the Duke of Edinburgh. Prince Philip has been a great friend of our family for many years, a relation which we have deeply valued. His service to his country will remain an inspiration to us all. We offer our sincere condolences to Her Majesty the Queen, the royal family and the people of the United Kingdom." Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi tweeted, "My thoughts are with the British people and the royal family on the passing away of HRH the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. He had a distinguished career in the military and was at the forefront of many community service initiatives. May his soul rest in peace." The Prime Minister will meet his cabinet this afternoon at 5 p.m. Downing Street has said. Ministers are expected to discuss the funeral arrangements for the Duke of Edinburgh.